Welcome back, everybody. It's your host here at Stranger Oddities and everything. So, actually, I was watching a interview kind of thing. It was with a singer of one of the modern, or not so much modern, I guess. I guess they're, well, I don't know. Anyways, a singer for a rock group that I had listened to back in my earlier teenage years and everything, but he said a good point. And one thing was he was talking about how people no longer go out and buy the records anymore. It's just everything is just heading to streaming, or just somehow, you know, that's all they care about. They just, you know, they just kind of tune in a different way. I kind of felt like it kind of reflected a little bit on me, because I'm one of those analog people that I still believe in just the old way of doing things. I still go out and buy physical media. I will still buy CDs. I still buy, I recently kind of bought, well, I guess within the last couple of few years, I've bought a pretty gigantic collection of vinyl. Now, a lot of people may not know that about the about me. I do buy a lot of vinyl records, and there's just something about holding the thing in your hand. You know, I actually did an unboxing of Metallica's recent San Francisco Symphony part 2 that they did. I was a big fan of the first one that they did. So, you know, it's really neat when you actually get the thing in your hand, like I got it right here. You flip through it and you actually see all the artwork that they did. You get to pull the sleeve out. You get to see this really gorgeous record that they have out. You know, it's a nice black, you know, record with the kind of off-gray center. S&M, too, Metallica and the San Francisco Symphony. It's really neat. You can see, too, where they scribed in on the record, and then towards the middle, on it was produced on Metallica's record press. That's really awesome. I still love this stuff. I remember my first cassette tape I ever bought. This was some years ago, many years ago. I bought a cassette tape, and the first one I ever bought was Bob Seger and the Silver Bullet Band. That was on cassette. My dad had a A-track in his car. Of course, I had a lot of cassette tapes growing up, Bryan Adams and what have you, Queen, and a lot of old classic rock stuff. You know, it's mainly because that's what my parents listened to, so yeah, I still listen to it today. And you know, I got it's just really neat. You got the booklet here, and you know, you open it up, and it's just awesome. The photos of you know, the lead singer and the whole orchestra and everything, and that's what I'm a big fan of. I'm just such a big fan of still seeing the physical media. I will always buy the records. I will always support purchasing the hard copies of all this stuff. You know, books, I will still go and purchase the books. I have a very large Stephen King hardcover collection. I collect a lot of the old ones, a lot of still the original covers and stuff like that. I'm just a really big fan of that. So it's really neat to, you know, hear other musicians kind of supporting that. And it's kind of sad how they don't really make much off of record sales and stuff, although they should. I played music for a number of years. I still kind of do, just for giggles' sake. Not so much serious. I had a couple of, you know, run-ins with some bands, and, you know, we got together, jammed a little bit, made some music. It's always been kind of my main focus point. I've always loved music, creating music, buying movies, creating, making movies, and all that kind of stuff. I always, even while looking back, when I was a kid, my parents finally bought me a camcorder, and back then it was a VHS tape that you stuck in there and you kind of recorded stuff. I used to go around the house and videotape all kinds of crazy stuff. Yeah, I had this, at the time, I had this German Shepherd dog out in the yard, and I used to go out there and try to, and I think I rubbed ketchup on her snout there, and I tried to make her look like Cujo or something like that, you know, trying to do all this kind of stuff. But even from that age, I was always fascinated with filmmaking and just the media of it all. I'm a VHS kid. I grew up with that. VHS tapes were just something really awesome to me. I had a lot of really oldies. I had a copy of A Dog Day Afternoon. And the video, they call it a big box. It was this really oversized VHS tape box that you opened it up and you took the cassette out and you put it in your VCR and, you know, video, you know, cassette recorder device. Back when we used to tape things off of the television, that's where that comes from. Just, you know, the my favorite TV shows or whatnot would come on, the Three Stooges or something. I'd stick that blank tape in there and into the VCR, set it to the correct channel, and you know, record it right off the television. That's what we used to do. You know, take the tape out and label it and write on what is it. And then we taped off TV, and I remember running over there and trying to pause it and stop it in between to cut out all the commercials, stuff like that. There was a movie that was chasing after. It was called Red Sun with Charles Bronson, Toshiro Mifune. Taped it off of the television on TBS station, and I actually taped it off of there. I had it for a long time on blank tape rolling around and stuff. And, you know, we actually went to a video store in Colorado, in Boulder. I don't know if it's even still around. It's called the Video Station. It literally is like one of the biggest video stores ever. It's like two stories of video. And they actually had that real VHS copy of that Red Sun. And, you know, man, I rented it and, you know, just to check it out, even though I had the blank tape version of it. And, you know, I also recall, you know, we used to set up two VCRs to copy and duplicate tapes and do all that kind of stuff. That was some really awesome times. And yeah, I still listen to my records. I still love my CDs. A portable CD player, that was a big thing when I was growing up. You know, of course, had a Walkman before that. So when the CD thing kind of hit, you know, that was a big deal. I remember that. This was long before those iPods and stuff like that. Those things were not even around. Those things weren't even a thing. You know, I didn't have a cell phone going through school and stuff. That was not something that was, you know, we didn't have that. We had a payphone. We had a payphone on campus. If you need to make a call, I guess you dropped a quarter. my dad used to say back in my day, we used to drop just a nickel to make a phone call. So, but no, you know, I still buy videotapes. There's some videotapes I wish I would have kept, because, man, I just looking back at that, I was like, man, I wish I would have kept some of those tapes. I actually just recently acquired some new tapes and stuff, and I bought the Kelly's Heroes on the big box because I saw it at the record store for a buck or two. Now, it reminded me of what I used to have, and, you know, I bought it, and I said, you know, I got to have this thing. So I went and bought it. So, yeah, I'm a huge supporter of the analog world. I still love it. That's just the way I've always been. I do like it. There is some things, I guess, out of necessity, you kind of modernize or go through it. And I'm not knocking the modern material or the, you know, these cell phones these days are pretty amazing. It's kind of almost unfair to call them a cell phone because they do so much, even though I'm clueless on how most of all that works. But you know, the fact that you can use it as a GPS system and find your way to somewhere you need to go, that's pretty amazing. Even myself as a drummer, I've always, you know, played on acoustic sets, but because of noise and neighbors and things, you know, you want to get cops called on you for noise complaints and stuff like that, ended up discovering, you know, trying out the electric sets and stuff. And so I went with that route because you can just plug in your headphones and really just, you know, play at your leisure and not have to worry so much about, you know, the neighborhood and the whole county kind of hearing what you're doing. So, you know, it does have its, you know, the modern age world is definitely in that, you know, change here. But preference wise, you know, I love DVDs. I love the Blu-rays. I was still one of those guys way back that resisted so much. I did not want to give up my VHS tapes. But as they dwindled away and they pretty much weren't around anymore, you had to, you know, go with DVD or Blu-ray. And I recall when DVD came out, it was like they were very, very special. Walmart had them in a locked up cabinet. I mean, there was only four or five titles out there, and they were expensive, man. They were they were 20 something bucks just for one of them. And that was a, you know, that was a lot of money considering that we were paying, you know, $5, you know, on a high for a VHS tape. In some cases, some of those VHS tapes are more expensive depending on, you know, if you could get it, if it was new or if it wasn't, whatever. So I would be one of those kids that was at the video store and trying to get them to sell me a floor model that was a rental, and they just, you know, they wouldn't do it. But I wanted all those old tapes. So, but I'm glad I grew up with a little bit of that. I really am. I've said it before. I said it many times. I never, ever will regret at least growing up with, you know, videotapes and some of the analog world that was still existent throughout my childhood before things went to the way they are now. I really do believe that the kids coming up now have really been shortchanged because they really do not know at all what they missed. And I am proud to say I think I was one of the last of that generation to see that. You know, I'm really glad that my mom did everything she could to provide me with the great childhood I had. I really do. Thank you. I love you, Mom. You know, yeah, I wouldn't trade my childhood for nothing. It was at least it was something that was the last of really the coolness. I'm sure, yeah, if I could go back in time, if they invented a time machine, I'd jump in it in a heartbeat. I'd be gone. let's go back to through time. So, but you know, we know that can't happen, but it is what it is, and here we are today. But I still buy my records. I still support buying records, buying a CD, whatever it is, flipping through the artwork and enjoy it and have it in your hands and just lay back and let that needle play the tune.